Hey friends, I'm Frederik, and today we're going to look at the Law of Demeter. Now, before we go into what the Law of Demeter is, I would like to look at some code with you. Okay, a quick scope. We are building a platform that manages movies, and this is a promo class. This class is responsible for making a poster with all the members of the crew in it. As you can see, we currently have a producer, a director, and a camera person. And we want these people to shine in our poster. So here is a poster class, and that just takes these functions and makes a poster from it and returns it. Don't really need to know too much about that one. Now, if we go into the movie class, you can see this is just a collection where all these functions are linked to a movie, and they return them and they set them. Now, if you go to a director class, you can see just as a string for now, this is just an easy example. So here we just go to the movie, get the producer, and from that producer, get a name. Okay, easy, right? You've probably seen an example like this in production before. Now, management comes in and tells you about the state of the movie and how it's going way beyond budget, and some roles might need to be revised. Okay, trouble in paradise. But don't worry, for now, it's not your role. But the same can be said for the camera person. The camera person role is sadly going away because who needs a camera person in a movie, right? And they notice that the stars don't get enough spotlight on them. So they want to include a lightning operator and remove the camera operator. Okay, not fun, but well, that's life. Let's dive back in the code and do these changes. Okay, easy enough. Let's drop the camera operator. Here is the camera class. Let's drop it. Add a lightning operator. Let's just call it lightning. And here it just takes a name. Let's just string the name. Initialize it. And add a getter, and the setter is not needed due to the constructor. Also, we need to update the movie class. Here is the movie class. Let's drop that camera person. And here again, the camera getter, and return the camera setter. Now we want to create a lightning person. So private lightning, that's a soldier name, and then add a fluent setter and get a getter. Okay, cool, we're done. We removed the camera and we added lightning, we updated the movie class, everything is fine and dandy, right? Or is it? I think we might have forgot about that get camera in the promo class. Let's take a look. So here we have the promo class, and as you can see, indeed, this movie doesn't know anything anymore about the camera operator. And again, this will fail, and this will fail. This is a liability we don't really want in our application. So you might be thinking, okay, no big deal, just update this class. But what if you have a very complex application, a big application, and you have to go through all of these seemingly unrelated files? What does a promo class actually have to do with binding itself to a camera operator? That doesn't actually make a lot of sense now, does it? You need to go through this entire application, go line by line, or just do a quick search, obviously, and try and deduct where this is being used in all of these obscure places. Now, as you probably figured out already by seeing the title of the video, this is all about the Law of Demeter. And this is where it really shines. So the law itself is nothing new. It's been in the Java world since, I think, 1987 or something. But it's not really that deeply ingrained in the development culture, I think. The law is actually very simple, but yeah, let's dive more into it. So it only has 5 simple rules, and they're all chained together. So first of all, it says you can only reference methods from your current class. Okay, simple enough. Or from the class's parameters. So all the top private or public key parameters you can also reference. Also, any objects created or instantiated in the class you can also use. And direct components or classes or global methods in the system. So if that sinks a bit deeper, you might realize that this is pretty restrictive. And I'm not going to disagree with you here. It is. I think the law is more something you have to keep in mind and not strictly follow all the time, because you're going to run into some issues later down the line. So let's now try and refactor the code we have here into something that could fit these rules more. So, okay, we're back in this Primo class. And here you can see the get camera is where the issue lies. Here you're going to get these names from the movie, from the producer, and then get a name. So let's look at those rules. First of all, we reference the movie, which is okay, because this is here reference to a parameter from the class itself. So that's all fine and dandy. But then we go a bit deeper into the get producers, and this is still okay, because you're referencing a method from this parameter. So that's all still good. But then you reference one even deeper where you can get the name. And this is where we go a little bit overboard. So there's actually a very easy solution here. Let's go back to our movie class. Let's go back to our movie class. And here we can see all these getters. What if we, do we really need to return those functions? Does the end user really need to know all that? Or do they just need to know who's actually involved with this production? So the name, that's just the name of the movie, we're going to keep that one. But let's remove the producer and director. I think we had the lightning at the bottom, yeah. My bad here. And here, let's make a public function get crew names. And just take the crew name. And this is just going to return an array. Yes, I can loop over them, but let's just keep it as readable as possible. Director, this director. Get name. Now you might be thinking, what's the difference here, right? Well, the thing is here, this is again a parameter, and it's just going to call something from inside of that class. So that's still in the scope of the law of Demeter. What do we still have? We have a producer, this producer, get name. And the cameraman we dropped, remember? So we still need the lightning. That's probably a better term for that. But it's lightning and get name. Oh, yeah, I probably didn't reference the lightning correctly. But okay, so that works. This can return an array. And we can now just go back to our promo class. And in this promo class, we can actually now do this. Return new poster. Up. And here we can reference this movie. Get crew names. And that will automatically return the array. So that's nice, right? Now we can think about some more upsides of this approach. Okay, let's go back to the class. Now, there are some extra benefits you might not be seeing right away. So here, in the poster class, in the promo class, you can see we now have this poster, which we create from the crew names. Now, the crew names, if you go to that movie class, here, that movie class. What if we now need to add another person to the crew? Okay, we can, for example, add the cameraman back. Camera operator, sorry. this. Yeah, we dropped it, but let's call her Julie. And now we don't have to update anything else, because here, in this function, here, it just takes those crew names. It doesn't need to know anything about the how the crew is handled and how it should function. So that's really easy. Also, another extremely big benefit is the testing. Previously, we would had to mock every getter, and from that getter, we need to mock every get name. So that's a lot of work. Here we just, in this movie mock, we only have to mock this get crew names and return an array. It's a lot simpler. Also, our class is now this instead of like the whole shebang. So this was a quick introduction to the Law of Demeter. Again, something to keep in the back of your mind while developing. Don't blindly follow everything and try how it makes sense in your application. This might all sound very simple and you might be very excited to jump into it, but you might bump into some more complex issues. For example, how do chaining work? Or a collection? How do these things work? Now, there's a lot of discussion in the Law of Demeter community. I'm not really part of that community, but yeah, who knows, you might be. So people aren't really convinced of what is the right thing to do here. Some people just straight up refuse to work with chained methods and workflows. But I personally believe that a chained method returns a new instance of itself. And as that is a node of thing in your application or your file, it's part of the second rule, so I think you can use it. But again, there's some confusion there. Some people like to use it, some people don't like to use it. Again, don't follow these rules to the letter, but you can see they make sense. So try and see what you want to do. So I hope you learned something new from the video. If you'd like to see more content like this, you can always subscribe to the channel. I try to cover things like these. I also try to cover some tools, tooling, and maybe some other techniques and stuff. If you want to request some issues or things to talk about, you can find my Twitter handle in the comments below, no, in the box that opens up. You can find it there. You can always tweet at me, or you can just drop a comment below and I'll get to it. I read all of those things. It's not that much at the moment, but still. Thanks for watching, and I'll hope to see you next time. So yeah, thanks. See you.